10 Greatest Military Blunders of World War II. Tied at number 10, the Philippines Liberation, 1944. Not a defeat, but an unnecessary operation that may have extended the war by months. After having been kicked out of the Philippines 2 years earlier, General Douglas MacArthur was itching to get back and convinced Roosevelt that he might lose re-election in 1944 if he didn't liberate the island chain he had so ineptly tried to defend in 1942. However, by 1944, the Japanese air and naval presence on the island had been largely nullified, and it was too far from Japan to be of use as a base from which to launch raids on its cities, leaving little reason to invade the place, other than because that's what Douglas wanted. And what Doug wanted, he usually got. The time spent securing the islands and the resources committed to doing so delayed the more important invasion of Okinawa in 1945 and probably extended the war by several months, but at least it gave MacArthur the chance to wade ashore the Leyte Gulf to proclaim that he had returned. Second tie at number 10, Kursk, Russia, 1943. Having apparently learned nothing from the trouncing he had taken at Stalingrad 6 months earlier, Hitler decides to launch yet another big offensive against the now large and well-entrenched Soviet defenders, this time at a place called Kursk, an important industrial city some 300 miles south of Moscow. Billed as the largest land battle in history, the Soviet lines bent but didn't break, and ended up costing the Germans pretty much the rest of the best of its army and air force, and initiating Germany's long and slow retreat back to Berlin, with all the unfortunate consequences for Hitler and the German people that eventually entailed. Number 9. Anzio, 1944. What is not well known to the average history buff is that American troops had a golden opportunity to finish off the Germans in Italy early on with their surprise landing at Anzio, Italy, a quaint little place just a hop, skip, and a jump from Rome. So taken by surprise were the Germans, in fact, that a few Yanks in jeeps managed to drive all the way to Rome without hindrance, demonstrating that the way was open for Allied forces and portending a major disaster for the Germans dug into the south of the city. Unfortunately, the Allied commander of the operation, Major General John P. Lucas, proved to be a bit timid and decided to consolidate his beachhead before pushing on to Rome, which gave the Germans time to move their forces and contain the Americans there for the next few months and costing Lucas his job. Had the man shown a little Patton-esque-like bravado, the Germans might have been forced back to the Austrian frontier 2 years earlier than they eventually were, and countless Allied and Axis lives might have been saved in the process. Number 8. Italy's invasion of Greece and Egypt, 1940-1941. With dreams of restoring the glory that was Rome, Mussolini unleashed his oversized but inept army against Albania. Yes, I said Albania. And Greece in the summer of 1940, and decided to push into Egypt from his colony in Libya as well. Not remarkably, Mussolini had his head handed to him by the British Greek forces in the Balkans and the British Allied forces in Egypt, forcing Hitler to have to send in his army to save his hapless ally. This ended up costing the Germans dearly, for it pulled valuable resources away from other fronts and delayed Hitler's timetable for the conquest of the Soviet Union, gumming up the whole affair. Chances are, had Mussolini followed Franco's lead in Spain and simply had Italy remain neutral, Germany may have won the war. Maginot Line and the Fall of France, 1940. Having apparently learned nothing from World War I, the French set about creating an impenetrable line of fixed defenses on its border with Germany, guaranteed to keep the Huns at bay. Called the Maginot Line, it proved to be every bit as formidable as advertised. The problem was, it didn't go all the way to the coast, leaving a 100-mile-wide gap that the Germans were able to plow through with relative ease in the spring of 1940, thereby encircling the British and French armies in Belgium and handing the French a humiliating defeat that they don't like to talk about to this day. Debate rages whether the Maginot Line would have stopped the Germans even if it had been complete, but considering how much warfare had changed since the trench warfare of World War I, it probably would have only slowed them down. Once the Germans breached it at any point, most likely the results would have been the same, just a little later in being realized. Number 6. Philippines Defense, 1942. General Douglas MacArthur's harebrained scheme to defend the entire archipelago from the Japanese in the spring of 1942 was doomed from the start. Scattering his supplies of food and ammunition throughout the islands in hopes of defending every square inch of the place only ended in disaster for his men when he was quickly forced to abandon the plan, along with the stockpiles of food and ammo, and pull them all back to the Batam Peninsula. After a few futile months of resistance, over 76,000 American and Filipino troops were starved into surrendering, leading to the greatest defeat in American military history. Not to worry though, old Doug hightailed it out of there before the end came and spent the rest of the war lobbying to be awarded the Congressional Medal of Honor for his brilliant defense of the place. Which he got, by the way. Number 5. The London Blitz, 1940. With the fall of France in June of 1940, England stood alone against the Germans, making the likelihood of a seaborne invasion of England, already in the planning stages, a very real possibility. Only Britain's undersized air force, the RAF, stood in the way of keeping the Germans' much-vaunted Luftwaffe from seizing air control and making a sea invasion possible. At first, the Germans were winning the war of attrition by attacking British airfields, but after a small-scale RAF bomber raid on Berlin on the 25th of August 1940 enraged the Führer, Luftwaffe Air Marshal Göring decided to retaliate by switching targets from the RAF airfields to London. In doing so, he gave the British a much-needed chance to regroup and rearm, the result being the Luftwaffe's eventual defeat and the cancellation of the invasion of England a few months later. Number 4. Invasion of the Soviet Union, 1941-1945. Hitler's ambitious plan to defeat communism on his own doorstep by knocking out the Soviet Union in one bold move very nearly worked, but it also forced him to fight a two-front war against two enemies, the USSR and the USA, that far outmatched Germany in terms of manpower and industrial capability. After Stalingrad in 1942, Germany was on the defensive, and defeat, pending some miracle weapon that never managed to emerge, was inevitable. Had Hitler finished off England first and secured his Western Front before taking on his Soviet foe and staying out of war with America in the process, history could well have had a very different ending. Number 3. Pearl Harbor, 1941. A well-planned and executed operation that resulted in a spectacular victory for Japan, it also planted the seeds for their own eventual defeat. In concentrating their efforts on the largely obsolete battleships, the Japanese pilots failed to knock out the major infrastructure on the island, the oil farms, repair shops, and munition storage facilities that made it possible for the Americans to use Pearl Harbor as their forward base of operations throughout the war. Had they done so, it would have forced the US to fall back to the West Coast, making operations in the Pacific far more difficult and probably extending the war by a year or more. The Japanese also failed to sink the aircraft carriers, their primary targets that were out to sea at the time and a force that would come back to exact retribution later on, or attack the submarine pens. This was truly a case in which short-term victory resulted in a long-term defeat. Number 2. Dunkirk, 1940. Having successfully encircled the combined Anglo-French army in northern France and Belgium in June of 1940, German forces were poised to deliver the coup de grace to the Allies when Hitler inexplicably ordered his armies to halt their advance just miles short of final and total victory. It was said he did this to make a point to his generals that he was the hero of the day, not they. As a result, over 300,000 British and French soldiers were able to be evacuated to England before the noose was closed, allowing them to fight again. Had they not been evacuated, it is doubtful the British could have stood up to the Germans and Italians in North Africa the following year, potentially altering the outcome of the war by permitting the Axis to take Egypt and the oil fields of the Middle East, in which case it really would have been game over. Number 1. Stalingrad, 1942. This is the battle which essentially cost the Germans the war. Hitler's ambitious plan to seize the oil-rich Caucasus region of the Soviet Union in the summer of 1942 ground to a halt on the shores of the Volga River at a city named after the Soviet leader Joseph Stalin. After months of brutal fighting that left hundreds of thousands dead on both sides and the city leveled, Hitler's man on the spot, Field Marshal von Paulus, found his army entirely surrounded and was forced to surrender over 250,000 men in February of 1943. Had Hitler allowed him to withdraw a few months earlier when victory was truly out of reach, it would have probably staved off Germany's ultimate defeat by months or possibly even years, giving them the time needed to develop an atomic bomb, perhaps. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button in the top right. Our channel has loads of other awesome videos just like this.